I'm going to explain the idea of reaction rate by looking at a couple specific examples to make clear what we mean when we ask, in this case, which reaction rate is higher. So what I've plotted is the concentration of reactant A as a function of distance down a plug flow reactor. It's an isothermal reactor. It's the same reactor for these two conditions. And the question is, if we have a second order reaction where the rate is proportional to a rate constant and the concentration of reactant raised to the second power, we want to know which reactor has the higher rate of reaction. So these are the same size reactors. And if we look at which reactor has the highest rate of reaction, we have to make clear we're not looking at which reactor has the highest conversion. So reactor one has the highest rate of reaction. And that's because the rate of reaction, minus KCA squared, or if you like, the rate that we're forming the product B is KCA squared. So this is the rate per volume. It's normally defined in kinetics reactor design textbooks. And what we're interested then in the entire reactor, the rate would just be for formation of B, would just be this integral over the reactor, over the volume, or I could write this integral over the distance times the cross-sectional area of the reactor. And since from this diagram, CA1 is greater than CA2, then reactor one has the highest rate of reaction. If the question is which reactor has the highest conversion, so the highest conversion now is reactor two. So the question might be how we obtain these two conditions. And if it's the same reactor and isothermal, then the molar flow rate of A entering reactor one must be much greater than the molar flow rate of A entering reactor two, so that a smaller fraction of the feed is converted, even though the rate of reaction is higher. Because of the high flow rate, the percentage converted is smaller. So let's look at a similar problem where we have diffusion and reaction within a porous catalyst pellet. The idea being reactant diffuses in, some of it reacts, the rest continues to diffuse in, and we set up a steady state concentration profile, which I've shown here for three catalysts. Again, we're looking at a second order reaction. And if we ask which has the highest rate of reaction, the answer is that catalyst pellet one has the higher rate of reaction. And it's the same reasoning that the total rate of reaction within the pellet, well, it would be an integral, the rate of reaction per volume integrated over the volume. Of course, we could integrate this over radius for the appropriate values to get volume. Again, because the concentration of A in pellet 1 is greater than that in 2, greater than that in 3, then highest concentration minus highest rate of reaction. Now, if we first look at this, we'd say, well, the concentration of 3 drops dramatically within this catalyst pellet, making us think that we've reacted the reactant A faster in catalyst pellet 3. However, if we say they have the same rate constant, and that's an important constraint, the same rate constant for each of these pellets, then to obtain the result for catalyst 3, we must have the diffusivity of 3 is lower than the diffusivity of 2, lower than the diffusivity of 1. For example, the pores are much smaller in catalyst 3 than in catalyst 1. So we have to be careful as what we're keeping constant, but if they have the same rate constant, then rate's proportional concentration, highest concentration means the highest rate of reaction.